So trade season is officially underway. We've seen the Blazers and Clippers Norman Powell trade, and now we have seen Caris LeVert being traded for the second time in 2 years now, going from the Indiana Pacers to the Cleveland Cavaliers in exchange for Ricky Rubio and a lottery-protected first-round pick this year. So what is going on, everybody? How is everybody doing? Today, we are doing our new look Cavs Caris LeVert rebuild. There was also 2 second-round picks included in this trade. The Pacers get the Rockets second-round pick this year and a 2027 Utah Jazz second from the Cavs. And then the Cavs are going to get a 2022 second-round pick from the Miami Heat. And I went full in-depth on my initial reaction and analysis on the trade on my second channel. Link to that is in the description. So I'm not really going to talk about the Pacers side of things, more the Cavs today. And I think there is a chance that the Cavs could make another trade at the deadline that involves Colin Sexton. So the 2K share with the updated start today standings, I downloaded, had injuries off, so Sexton will either be traded one by me or he will not be playing for the rest of the year. But there is a chance I could try to trade Sexton. I think the Cavs won't be trading Love. He's not been terrible this year either, like in the previous years, and his contract is kind of like big still. But we'll see what we want to do with Colin Sexton. And I don't really know, honestly. I'm kind of torn what I want to do. We are not going to be playing Sexton for either the rest of the year, or we're going to be moving him, like I just said. So I will look at offers for him. Well, let me see what the rotation would look like with LeVert in there. So I really like the trade for the Cavs. If it's the 20th pick in the draft, I think that's well worth it. Getting 2 years of LeVert, who could be a nice secondary shot creator next to Garland, can provide some floor spacing. So I'm a big fan of that. I think I'm going to go like 34 to Garland. I love this front court, man. It's probably a top 5 front court in the league minimum. And Allen's 23. Mobley's a 20-year-old rookie, I guess, at this moment, which is kind of mind blowing. Got to figure out, like, yeah, like we could upgrade this bench. We really can. Like Rondo and Winler are going to play minimum minutes. Jetty and Love, I guess Love, we should probably give a decent amount more minutes to. We can go something like that. Yeah, I guess. I'm going to start a Coro over Markkanen. So if I were to package a Jetty Osman and Colin Sexton package, what could that look like? A part of me, as a Knicks fan, always wanted them to do maybe like Alec Burks or Sexton. That's not happening. And okay, yeah. Why would the Clippers do that? Of course, I would love that. We could be in the Christian Wood market. Maybe they would want the bird rights on Sexton because you can match any contract he gets in free agency. But we don't really need bigs, and I got offered mainly bigs. So let's simulate a couple days here to the deadline, and then we'll figure out what we want to do. So we beat the Pacers. That game is currently going on right now. The Pacers were up by double digits at the end of the first quarter. And we are going to go up against the Spurs here. Let's see how we do. And we'll see what LeVert did in these two games as well. But the simulation is just taking forever. Against the Pacers, did LeVert play? He did. He had 11 points in that game. That's probably now they're just stud. Jetty, showing why I shouldn't trade him. All right, so we ended up losing to the Spurs 124-108. Garland had 25. Very inefficiently, though. Okay. So, I don't know. Well, I guess LeVert hasn't done too much yet with us. So let me go here. It's trade deadline day. If I were to throw in Sexton, maybe just by himself. Interesting idea, but why would the Sixers do that? We could pick up Patrick Williams now. I feel like a team that doesn't need Sexton this year would pull the trigger. The Pelicans could, and I can get their unprotected first. That's kind of a risky offer. So you know what? I think I'm going to keep Sexton for the rest of the year. I think I'm going to go that route and then either sign and trade him, or just bring him back and maybe have like LeVert be the sixth man and roll with Sexland for the future. Can I reset him right now by any chance? I can't. At least he'll be restricted because he's going to be very pissed after this year. Love would come back for 5 mil. I mean, he would be 35 then. So I'm not really going to pull the trigger on that. So I just want to be a top 6 seed in the Eastern Conference and just avoid the playing tournaments. I'll see you guys at the end of the year, and let's hope that's the case. And we did drop off a little bit, which kind of sucks. We end up as the 8th seed. So we just need to win one playing tournament game to get our spot. I mean, if we lose the playing tournament, we get our first round pick this year, which would be kind of a disappointment because I want to see the Cavs in the playoffs, and they've been good enough where I believe they should be making it in real life, and I'd be happy to see them make the playoffs for once without LeBron James. I've never seen that in my life since I became an NBA fan. So Evan Mobley, all rookie first team, very deserving. So we are going to be taking on the Boston Celtics in round one of the playing tournament, which is a tough matchup. Yeah, they didn't really make any trades at the deadline. We are going to be without Colin Sexton, obviously. So I think I'm going to probably kick out Winler from the playoff rotation. Rondo, 10 minutes. Jetty can get like 17. We'll go 22 to Love. We'll go 20 to Markkanen. I'd like to go 35 to Garland. I guess we'll go 32 to LeVert. And then we'll go 33 to the front court. So under JB Bickerstaff, that is three-star defense. Yeah, I think I definitely want to switch that up in the offseason. I don't really want to be a defensive-minded team. So let's see what happens. Actually, before that, I would like to show you the player stats from this year just to see what, like, Jared Allen did, 15 and 11. He might be an all-star in real life. Like, Darius Garland was our best player. He is an all-star in real life. So, like, Allen could be a replacement. There's Caris LeVert. Evan Mobley's a superstar already. Kevin Love had a solid season. Shot well from the line and from three. Not from the field. So, Okoro, not great. Not great. But we'll see if we can knock off the Celtics and go to round two here. But it's going to be tough going into TD Garden, beating Tatum, beating Jaylen Brown. We have a back-and-forth game right here. We have a good third quarter, but blow it. And we end up losing the fourth quarter game by 2 points. Oh, yikes. Okay, so we are now one game away from possibly not even making the playoffs. We have the Atlanta Hawks here. It's a very good team. Oh, all right, at least we are home for this. And this is to be the 8 seed, which I would like to be. All right, we are blowing them out right now. So the Cavs are making the playoffs for the first time without LeBron since forever. So we end up winning by 35 points. Garland 28 and 10. Allen 23 and 10, and we are going to be taking on the Philadelphia 76ers, who have Ben Simmons. All right, game one against the Sixers, we pick up the L by 13. I would like to win two games. I feel like we're good enough to win two against Philly, and there's one of them. We win by three on the road, and we stole one at the Wells Fargo Center. That is fantastic. Can we go up 2-1? Damn, we do lose at home by 8 points. All right, how's Caris LeVert in the playoffs? Okay. All right, making, like, Caris LeVert not performing is making me really want to extend Colin Sexton and not trade him as we lose by 10 here. Damn. LeVert was solid. Garland has not been good for us in the playoffs, but it is a lot of these guys' first, like, playoff matchups as we end up getting gentlemen swept, which is a disappointing way to end the year. But basically, like, LeVert's played in one playoff series, right? Were the Pacers in the playoffs last year? No, because they got Dort in the lottery. So, yeah, like, the Pacers weren't in the playoffs last year. They lost in the play-in tournament, I think, to the Wizards or to the Hornets. Well, LeVert's played in one playoff series with the Nets. Garland never. Allen won with the Nets. Mobley never. Markkanen, he maybe played with Chicago one of these years. I don't remember. Like, Love, we know, has won an NBA championship. Okoro, never. Rondo, NBA championship. But a lot of these guys didn't have a lot of playoff experience. So, I'm fine with that. It is what it is. Like, 2K didn't give me a good finish off to the season, which is fine. The Clippers win it all. Kawhi's your finals MVP. Freaking LeBron James retires. What? So does Greg Popovich. Imagine an NBA world without LeBron and without Popovich. Arguably the greatest player and coach of all time. Arguably. So we have a lottery pick, which is good. That pick is going... Or no, we don't have a lottery pick. We were a playoff team. Duh. And ignore that. That was stupid. Pacers get the pick at 17. Honestly, looks pretty good for them. But we got LeVert next year still. All right, so it's the NBA draft time and we don't have any picks. But we do have 36 and we have 56. I could try to package those to get a first round pick, which I wouldn't mind. And I think, like, Winler and 36 should be able to get me back into the first round. I'm going to try to give the Rockets their 36th pick. We're giving Miami this pick. And we're going to give them Dylan Winler for 21. Would they do this? They will. Perfect. So now we have the 21st pick in the draft. I'll take that. And we have a chance to draft Johnny Davis out of Wisconsin at 21. Yeah, that's a steal. So we have plenty of good wings on this team. LeVert, Okoro, Jetty Osman, Johnny Davis. We'll see what's going on with Colin Sexton. If that's going to be a sign and trade or I'm going to keep him? I don't know. He's going to be extended the qualifying offer. Like, no matter what, we will be matching his contract. We will for anything. I'm hoping he gets offered a deal, but I could work out an own deal or a deal with myself. I mean, if he does get an offer, I can know that that team is interested and I could trade him there. 2K, stop telling me to renounce the rights on him. So the Nets are interested. What? 4 years, 110? Oh, that's so much money for Colin Sexton. That's what? $23 million a year? Oh, just under $23 million a year? Jeez. No, that's $27 million a year. Wow. What's the $28 million? Yeah, math lessons from Strauss. But we are going to match that. We know the Nets are interested. I mean, you're not going to trade me James Harden for Colin Sexton. But we could look at Sexton deals. Simmons? No, I need like a true two. McCollum is there, but I don't like having two small guards. I don't really like him at the two. I'd rather have a better defensive shooting guard. I mean, we could go out and get Josh Hart. I'm sure the Pelicans would be interested, so we could try to work out a trade with them. I'm sure Dallas would be interested as well. I mean, there's definitely teams like that would really like love having Colin Sexton on their teams. Just gotta figure out what's the best deal for us. We could try to snag Devin Vassell and Jakob Poeltl, who could be like a baller backup center for us. And we get Vassell for Colin Sexton. Because they would be interested in him. I think we could be interested in that. Like, I do kind of want to experiment with no Sexton. And then I guess LeVert starts at the two, or we groom Johnny Davis to be the long-term two. 6'5", he's got some length, can shoot the three, got good D. I don't know. That's something. Okoro, they moved down to a shooting guard. I don't know if he was always that. And I think Vassell gives us, like, a former lottery pick. We get a great backup center in Jakob Poeltl, and we have, like, arguably the best big man rotation in the league with Allen, Mobley, Markkanen, Love, Poeltl. That'd be pretty good. 25 mil's a lot of money for Sexton. Let's see if they'd even accept this. I don't even know if they would. They say no, because, like, their original offer was Joshua Primo. But I'd rather have Vassell, honestly, than Primo. They just took Jaden Ivey. I don't really want Joshua Primo. I feel like he's pretty, like, raw as a prospect still, and I'd have to groom him. They don't want that. I mean, is there a player I could throw in that you'd like? Lamar Stevens, and of course you can't afford that at all. I don't really want to give up any first round picks because we don't have a lot of those. So they're not biting on this deal, which is quite unfortunate. I doubt they'd want to give up Keldon Johnson or DeJounte Murray. All right, we'll go back to that. I mean, this trade, this was a complete fantasy style rebuild. I'd love to do that, but I want this to be a little bit more realistic. And do I want Primo? I want Vassell. I really want Devin Vassell. I mean, could we do Bree? Like, I don't know. I really don't know what to do. What about Sexton and a second for Vassell and Derek White? They would want Jetty Osman for Poeltl. Okay, do we? Yeah, I'll do this 2-for-3 trade. So Colin Sexton, 2 seconds, and Jetty Osman, who's in the final year of his deal. Good wing, too. And he's like one of the more veterans on our team. So this hurts giving him up. But we're getting a good veteran in Derek White. You could say he's on a bad contract now after the season he just had. We're getting Jakob Poeltl, who's an expiring deal. I don't know if we're going to be able to afford him, but we're trying to win now. And we get Vassell, who I think has a lot of potential on the wing for us. So they are going to agree to that deal. And that might be the biggest move of the video. So looking at our team right now, I think we have a good rotation. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Like, yeah, we have plenty of guys to play next year. All right, so, like, there might be an odd man out of this rotation. I really don't know what to do. Am I not going to be able to play Johnny Davis? Like, 11 deep is tough. And I don't really think I need to play Love. He's going to regress a lot. Like, Okoro, he's going to be an odd man out. Mark and I want to give a lot of minutes to. Same with LeVert. Okay, I don't think I have a trade in mind. But let me figure out this rotation really quickly. Okay, so I think there is a chance Johnny Davis gets, like, 7 minutes this year, which kind of sucks. And there could be a deadline deal for me if I feel like I don't need Poeltl and Love and Markkanen all off the bench, which could definitely happen. So, can I give two more? Okay, Allen's got 30, he's got 30. And then I'm going to give two more. LeVert's going to want to get 23 minutes. Nah, we got to go like 25 to these two. Okay, so 32 to Garland, 25 to the wings, 30 to the front court, 24 to Markkanen. Jeez. 18 to Okoro, 17 to Derek White, 17 to Poeltl, 15 to Love, 7 to Johnny Davis. I think there's a big chance we see a deadline deal. I'm going to change JB Bickerstaff's preferred system to balance. And yeah, like, we just have a deep rotation right now. So I'm just hoping we win games. Nobody gets too unhappy. We figure everything out. I don't know, like, Love, I don't know. Let me change Love to a power forward. And I think I want to change Okoro to a small forward. Love to a power forward, Okoro to a small forward. Perfect. So I'll see you guys at the trade deadline. How we're doing. Probably will have to make a trade or a big decision. Okay, so we just became the 2 seed. We were kind of the 3 seed all year. We just became the 2 seed right before the trade deadline. We're 11 games over 500. Okay, this is kind of where we were last year, real life right now, at the trade deadline, and we kind of fell off a little bit. So I think there's a part of me that I don't need all this talent. Like, Derek White, not great at all. He's not been good whatsoever. I don't think anybody's gonna want that contract. But like, it's gonna be tough to move Derek White, and I feel like Poeltl would be the guy to move. He's not getting a lot of playing time. He's really good though. I just won't be able to move Love. If there was a buyout market or if that was a thing, I mean, I could technically buy out Love. He's not been great this year. You know what? I'm gonna technically buy out Love. I'm gonna release Kevin Love. We have so many guys, and I'd rather play Poeltl because I want the opportunity to extend him. I don't think I'm going to be able to move Derek White for something that deems realistic. So we're going to release Kevin Love. I apologize to anybody. This is technically us buying him out. He can get more playing time. Hopefully he signs with the championship team. So yeah, we just released Kevin Love. I could play Johnny Davis a little bit more now. I want to give him like 12 minutes a night. Derek White's probably going to go down to like 15. Okoro, I would like to give 22. Poeltl, 22. Let's go 30 to 1 to the front court. And then let's go 28 to LeVert, 27 to Vassell. So I'm excited about that. 3.5-star balance. Let's hope that that doesn't hurt us too much. And we can end up as the top seed. Okay, yeah. Also, let's extend Darius Garland on a 4-year deal. LeVert, we will bring back on a 2-year deal also at a fairly reasonable contract. So Ja Morant wins MVP and we end up as the 1 seed. Let's go. The Cavs are a dominant team here in the Eastern Conference. Shout out to Time Lord. Yeah, that's most improved. Do we get anybody on an NBA team? Shout out to Ben Simmons in Philly. All NBA second team, no Cavs. Third team, nah, no Cavs. We actually got no Cavs at all. Sick. All right, but we're the one seed. Who are we taking on in the playing tournament? The Miami Heat, okay. Tough round one matchup. They got JD Davis and they got Tim Hardaway Jr. now. They still got Hero coming off the bench. All right, so Garland ended up with 21.5 and 9 assists. It's not an all-NBA season. I mean, his efficiency wasn't great, though. Mobley, 17 points, 9 rebounds. Very good season. He could have been all-NBA team unless I missed it. There's LeVert, not bad. Hopefully he steps up in the playoffs. Markkanen was a lot better this year, I think. Jared Allen was really good still with less minutes played. Okoro, very good third year from Okoro. There's Devin Vassell, good season from him as well. Derek White was better to end the year. Still not great. There's Johnny Davis, who I don't think is going to crack the rotation for the playoffs. I think we're going to go with the more established veterans. So White can get like 17, Poeltl 22, 24 to Okoro. Let's go 33 to Garland. I might go 25 to Vassell, 32 to the front court, and we'll go 30 to LeVert. And we'll go one more to Markkanen. Okay, so under JB Bickerstaff, are we 4.5 or 4? No, we're still 3.5. So can we beat the Miami Heat? We should. We really should get a round one victory, and we win game one by 17. Evan Mobley gives me 30-9. Garland with a great 22-8. Come on, let's go up 2-0. That's what I'm talking about. We beat him by 10 points. Mobley with 21-14. There's Jimmy Butler. All right, we're two games away from winning a playoff series, which would be pretty sweet, but we lose by 3 here. Garland had a great game. So did Markkanen. Damn, please don't let him tie it up. Yes, 3-1. So better than 2-2. Man, Jimmy's been going off in these games, but it has not nearly been enough. Garland, Markkanen, Mobley, LeVert, all stepping up. And let's win in 5. Yes, let's go. We make light work there of the Heat. Shout out to Markkanen, LeVert, and Garland, all scoring over 20 there. All right, so now we got Philly, a chance for revenge for beating us last year. I think we're suited to beat them. Jared Allen versus Joel Embiid and Garland shows why he's the better point guard in this series. 39-10, Mobley and LeVert going off as well. Come on, let's take game 2. Yes, let's go. We won by 13. Garland with 21-10, LeVert with 18-9. There's Allen, Markkanen, and Mobley, Okoro, all scoring in double figures. 2-1. All right, lose by 14 at the Wells Fargo Center. 52 combined between these guys. Let's just win game 4, please. No. Ugh, we give up 140. That's brutal. Come on, let's drop 140 in game 5. Yes, okay, we win by 2. I don't care how much. Win's a win. Tobias Harris is really dropping 45 on us. And we're going to a game 7, of course. I could have guessed it. And I'm going to simcast this, and I'm going to stress out, and we're probably going to lose at home. Where are we? The Quicken Loans Arena. Not a good first quarter. All right, second quarter. What's that third? Okay, not terrible, but a beautiful start to the fourth. We're up by 4. Come on. Yes! What a fourth quarter! Let's freaking go! We had scored by 14 in the fourth. Garland with a double-double. Allen with a double-double. Markkanen hits 4 threes. Mobley with a double-double. LeVert's been kind of like a passing god in these playoffs. Let's go! And we're in the conference finals. All right, and we're taking on the Wizards, who are 17. And these are the stats throughout the playoffs. Like, everybody's kind of been stepping up. We're killing it right now. Wizards as a 17. Oh, don't have Beal, but they have James Harden and Paolo Banchero now. Okay, Dinwiddie off the bench. I know they're going to try to make a play for Draymond Green. It's a bonus. And we lose game 1 by 6. Oh, well. can we not lose to the 7 seed? Okay, they swept the Pistons and they beat the Hornets in 7. But we do win game 2 by 8. Okay, we absolutely need to win game 3, 100%, and we do. Whew, it's a massive win. We won by 16. Garland with 36. Mobley with a double-double. Come on, let's win game 4. No, they tied up. Oh, they won the close one. That might be it. Thomas Bryant, really? Hopefully that's not a turning point. Yes, we're up 3-2. Let's go. We win by 9. One game away till the NBA Finals. Come on, let's win game 6. I don't need 2 game 7 series in a row. And we're in the finals. Yes, sir. Let's go. That's what we should be doing. What a fourth quarter. Wow, we were actually up by 2 heading into the fourth, and then we got scoring by 15. Garland with 27-10, Allen with 25-7, and we are taking on the, come on, give me the Spurs, give me Sexton versus us, that'd be sick. No, the Suns win in 7. So it's looking like the trade has worked out for both teams. Yeah, all right. They go to the conference finals, we go to the NBA finals, seems like a win-win to me. Oh, but now we have to take on a really good Suns team. And I mean really good, at least like with that starting 5. So I'm scared. I don't feel good about this. Yeah, game 1, we lose it overtime by 5 at home. Oh, that's going to kill me. Game 2, yes, that's a huge win. What a defensive performance. We hold them to 85 points. 18 in the second, 16 in the fourth, 20 in the first. We're down 2-0 or 2-1. God damn it. All right, game four in Phoenix in the walking stick, talking stick arena, resort arena. Not looking good. We're down by 12. All right, huge third quarter though. Huge third quarter. Huge second half. Yes, go. Let's go. What a third quarter. Yes, Garland. Yes, Mobley. Yes, Allen. All right, game five. We're sim-casting each game. I don't care. At home. Come on. We need this win. Not a good first quarter. Not a good second quarter. Come on. Come on. We got to come back in the fourth. We got to come back in the fourth. Oh, we came back. Yes. Yes. What a fourth. Oh, my God. Don't blow it, please. Please don't blow it. Yes. 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 What a fourth quarter performance. We outscored by 20. Holy shit. We had four guys score 20 plus. And we were one game away from winning the NBA Finals. Okay. Everybody calm down. Everybody relax. Come on. Road win here. Road Warriors. Let's do this. Down by 10. Good second quarter, though. Great second quarter. Okay. Fell apart at the end. We're down by 9 in the fourth. We've been a second half team. Let's see what happens. I think we're going to a game 7. Yeah, we lose by 8. Garland gives me 30-8. Ugh, Levert. All right. Game 7. I'm not ready for this. Game 7 of the NBA Finals. Cavs Suns, man. Let's do this. Let's go Let's go quarter by quarter. First quarter at home. Not bad. I'll take that. Okay, it's tied. All right. Tied game after 1. Okay. Garland's off to a great start. Vassell hit a 3. Markkanen 0 for 2. Okay. And then who's balling out for them? Booker. Booker versus Garland. That's what this game is going to be. Vanderbilt versus Kentucky. SEC matchup. All right. End of the second quarter. I'd rather be us than them. Let's freaking go. We outscore them 32-18. That's our defensive mentality in that second quarter. That's Allen, Vassell, Mobley, Okoro for you, man. Those are our defensive studs. White as well. Let's have a good third. Let's not choke it. Perfect. We're up by 21, guys. We are 9 minutes away from winning the NBA Finals. It's been Booker and a whole lot of nothing. Come on, just don't blow this. Don't blow this. Let's go. We're up by 17. Yes. Markkanen with 23-9. What a performance. We got a core of point guard. What the hell? Mobley with 28-10. He's too good. Kick it out to Pirtle, who's not a three-point shooter, so I don't know why I did that. Oh my God, we really have the biggest lineup of all time out here. I don't like this at all. I actually haven't jumped into a game in a fat minute. All right, out in the post. Let's see what he can do on Aiden. Texas on Arizona, and it looks like Arizona wins that one. All right, so I kind of want to get some subs in. They got Nemanja Bjelica out there. They got Nikola Jovic. I could have drafted him, but I went with Johnny Davis, who we haven't seen in the playoffs. I'm going to win it all without him. So I'm going to call a timeout. I'm going to get Garland and such in. So Garland in this game, he's got, really? It's not going to come up in the top. What happened? Is it not up on the deep end anymore? I don't know. I don't know why that won't come up, but oh well, there it is. 22-12. That is absurd. Levert's got 14. Man, I'm more worried about their box scores than trying to score. Oh, kick that out. Let's go. Who's that for 3? Devin Vassell. Let's go. He's got double figures on the night now. He knocks down that 3, and any comeback is done. Allen with a double-double, 5 assists. Man, this Cavs team is so, like, rootable. I don't know. So likable, I guess. Like, I would love a Cavs championship. I don't think it happens. Sexton being hurt. Rubio getting hurt. I think Sexton hurts more because they were never going to trade Sexton, but I think Rubio getting, like, which I don't think, Sexton gets traded. I'm talking way too fast. But, like, Rubio getting hurt, I think, like, obviously that brought him Levert. So, like, I don't think that really hurt them too much, even though Rubio was playing at an insane level. Just both of them getting hurt really sucked. But yeah, I would love for the Cavs to do well and make it to the conference finals and be like one of those teams like the Suns of last year. I don't think they're as good, but I think they're very close to being it. They have a great foundation of Allen, Mobley, and Garland. I think they just need that wing. Not like a 20-point per game scorer wing, just somebody that is going to give them good defense, three-pointers, assists. I don't know if that's going to be Levert. I don't know if that's going to be Okoro in his development. Great steal there by Jay Crowder, but they just need that. They won't have their first this year. Maybe it comes in a Colin Sexton sign and trade and they can get a first. I don't know, but that's like, I love the Cavs, man. I think they're super likable. And who knows? Maybe they do package Jetty Osman. I mean, I don't think they want to trade Osman. Like, I think they'd prefer just to move Sexton because their bench is still pretty weak as it is, and they probably want to have like a good 9-man rotation for the playoffs. So who knows? Maybe we'll see a Sexton deal. I think it would cost a lot to get rid of him off the Cavs. So, like, I think my dream of, like, Alec Burks for Sexton wouldn't happen. I'm trying to think of, like, players in my mind. Like, if they offered Sexton and Jetty Osman for Marcus Smart, does Boston say no? Probably. I don't know. Like, does Sexton for, you probably, like don't want, like, how'd that go in? I was going to say, like, Terrence Ross and Gary Harris now. I'm trying to think of, like, bad teams. Like, Sexton for Jeremy Grant? I don't know. I don't think Cavs, they don't need Jeremy Grant, though. That'd be a terrible fit. I think they need a wing that doesn't really need the ball in their hands. Like, I don't even think it'd be worth it doing it for, like, Eric Gordon. I'm trying to think of, like, other wings that have been on the market. Like, I'd love Dorian Finney-Smith on the team, but, like, Dallas would not trade him. As that was actually kind of filthy there by Garland as the buzzer expires. All right, so yeah, Finals MVP is Darius Garland, man. This Cavs team is sick. And, like, they just had a crazy comeback against the Pacers. They are just so much fun to watch. I'm, like, still thinking on this, like, Colin Sexton deal. Like, where would his value be at and what would you want? Like, you wouldn't do him for DiVincenzo. No, I think DiVincenzo, it sucks because he's lost a lot of his value this year. I'm just thinking, like, who would take a flyer on him? I really don't know. Like, Portland would... But who would you want from Portland? Like, all their wings are either hurt or just not good. You probably don't want, like, Malik Beasley. I don't know. I'm just kind of going through some of these teams here and just thinking of kind of players off the top of my head that would still be on these teams that, like, you would want. Yeah, I don't really know. So you guys can kind of let me know down below what maybe a Sexton trade would look like. I'm not going to really speculate anymore because there's a chance he gets traded between now and Thursday's deadline. And if not, hey, they can look to sign and trade him in the offseason or bring him back and have a better depth or just a better rotation with LeVert and Sexton in there instead of just one. So yeah, let me know what you guys think. Hope you guys did enjoy. Drop a like if you did. Let me know what you think of the trade down below. You know we're going to be coming out with these rebuilds all week. So I love you guys and I'll catch y'all on the next one. Peace. Also, no Pacers won. I don't know if I mentioned that before. I might have. But yeah, no Pacers rebuild because I'm expecting them to move Turner, Sabonis, Warren later on. So yeah, don't look out for that until Thursday. Maybe that'll be like the team, like the Magic last year, where I did a 10-year rebuild because they blew it up. So I'm hoping to do that. Love you guys. Catch you on the next one. Peace.